All right, fellow Dragon Ball enthusiast out there. Today I have something pretty interesting and perplexing to discuss with you guys. Sorry. About October 14th, or maybe sometime last night or early this morning, I can't remember, a new Dragon Ball website simply entitled, Dragon Ball Z 2018, was suddenly licensed, suddenly popped up, and, as some of us will remember, Dragon Ball Z 2013.com, or rather, yes, 2013 and 2015, were for Resurrection F and Battle of Gods, respectively. So, could this new website, guys, be a little teaser that the next Dragon Ball Z movie could potentially be coming next year for 2018? Now, like I said, guys, literally all the website says is Dragon Ball 2018.com, and then, basically, the name of the company that created the URL, and it says details been withheld. Now, I know with Battle of Gods and Resurrection F, the website stated that Toei on the URL, but for right now, maybe this is just a little teaser saying, Akira, the guy that works on the manga for Dragon Ball Super, and Toei Animation could be planning the next Dragon Ball Z movie for 2018. Now, the question's already been raised by, people like, Geekdom 101 or Alex from Unreal Gaming, that this could potentially, slow down, Dragon Ball Super's process, or rather, if this is a, new movie project, is it going to follow the continuity of Super, or what I would prefer actually is if it would be like an old school DBZ movie and sort of have its own standalone side story. I mean, it can still be considered canon by Akira as long as he's involved, but I would actually want, if this does turn out to be the next DBZ movie, I would want a theatrical release, but it be done in the way that all the old classic Dragon Ball movies were done. You know, like maybe, and oh, I know this is gonna get people fired up, maybe that final Broly movie that people have been bellyaching Toriyama-sensei about for ages, or hey, maybe even, and this is what I would really be hoping for, a movie where Goku and Bardock finally get to meet each other. I mean, guys, can you imagine that? Like, some movie and Akira can make this side story canon somehow, I know it, but wouldn't it be cool to see Goku in some way be able to either bring back Bardock and maybe not Planet or King Vegeta, but to be able to bring back Bardock and the two of them maybe have to deal with maybe Chilled or some other ancient enemy of the Saiyans that has never been revealed before, or hey, maybe we could even get a more extended version of a plan to eradicate the Saiyans, you know? Like, this could finally be Akira's chance to elaborate on plan to eradicate the Saiyans, because hey, that material was never translated into English, so maybe this could possibly be an actual full extended story of that. But the overall message of this video, guys, is that at this point, it is not confirmed at all that Dragon Ball will be getting a new movie in 2018, but all I am saying is that this is exactly how the two previous movies were lined up. So there you go, and let's hope that this is a new movie, because I think it is about time that Goku and the rest of the Z Fighters return to the big screen. Oh, and one more point I wanted to make about this. As far as whether this would interfere or slow down Super in any way, I do think that Dragon Ball Super would have had to take a bit of a break, except I think people are forgetting one key factor. Akira Toriyama created an entire department of his own choosing for Dragon Ball, so he and Toro Taro could concentrate on Super, but he could still be the overseeing consultant for the 2018 project, as long as it pans into something. So there you go, guys. If we get any more information, I'll be sure to let you know.